Yo guys, welcome back to my channel. My name's AJ. If you haven't, make sure you do hit that like and subscribe. Today, I'm gonna be teaching you guys how to remove lock nuts without a lock nut key. Now, I'm gonna be continuing working on my EG as I don't have parts yet. I've been waiting for parts. Why do parts have to take so long? Who knows? But today, I'm gonna be showing you guys the DIY way of removing those lock nuts. Now, I've never done this before, so you're probably gonna watch me fail. But those of you who haven't done it before, it's just a task and a hurdle that you can jump and take on. So if I can do it, I'm sure you guys can do it. Anyways, I look forward to showing you. So I'm gonna continue working on this. So something between an 18. I'm gonna try 3/4. Ooh. That is kind of close. No, I'm gonna go, what's more than 3/4? 11/16. No! So the 3/4 kind of spins, but it doesn't spin. So if you guys don't already know, the standard method is to put a socket on over the lock nut and hammer it in just so it just fits and grasps onto some of that metal. So today I'm gonna be trying that. I'm gonna be hammering in a socket. I believe it's gonna be an Imperial socket. I'm not exactly sure what size, but I'm gonna be tackling this issue and I'm gonna take out these wheel nuts so I can put some brakes in the car and so the car actually works. So that is my main goal today because I do need a daily. It's a bit hard. Mum and I are sharing a car at the moment. I mean, who likes to share cars, right? So here goes nothing. Let's try the 3/4 then, which is doing nothing but spinning. Wow. This car is proving harder to work on than I expected. Never mind, I can't take them off so easily. Alright guys, things actually didn't go so well when it came to removing the lock nuts. None of my nuts fit. I tried to put a 3/4 on and an 18 on with a mallet, didn't work just because it's an in-between size. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be actually traveling down to a nearby mechanic. These guys, the names are Tire Master, and they're gonna be removing these lock nuts for me. Fingers crossed.
Hi guys, my name is Bill from Tire Master. AJ came in today to us with his Honda Civic. The issue is to removing his lock nuts. We're gonna show you today, guys, how to get it done. He came to us before with his old E86. We do it all pretty much. If you think you got a lock nut you can't remove, you can look it up online on YouTube. And it's normally not that hard, but if you have an issue and you can't remove it, you can come down to us and we can get it done for you.
Whoa, guys, look at all these tires. What the fuck? There is walls and walls and walls of tires. I feel like I'm going through a maze right now. Oh my goodness. And it just keeps on going and going and going. What the hell? So, I've used Tire Master a few times. They've helped me out undoing bolts and nuts on my 86, on my Turbo 86. They did also change my tires for me, and they're also gonna help me with my Honda Civic.
Well, another car with a bit of a lock nut issue, which is lucky it's not a BMW because they're the worst. With lock nuts issues, it's a Honda, so hopefully it's gonna be an easy one. We're using the worst tools today. Well, hopefully we have the exact size because some of them are a bit tricky with sizing.
Well, I tried to put an 18 on and a 3/4, but the 3/4 was too big, 18 was too small.
That seems too big.
19 was too big as well. Oh, it's you got it? The lock nut there?
Seems like.
So what tools are you using?
That's just that. Especially okay. Made for lock nut. Normally does most of them.
Mm-hmm.
Some they won't work, like those new BMW one with the security bearing around them that it won't work at all. Okay, that's holding. Oh shit. Let's hope it's off. Not slipping.
Oh my goodness, moment of truth. So how often do you get people who can't take their lock nuts off?
A weekly, man.
Really?
Weekly.
Oh damn.
We had two M3s with broken lock nut a few days ago, and yeah, they both had the same issue, but they're much harder.
Oh.
So yeah.
Oh, good work, man. Nice.
Just as simple as that. It's sometimes just as long as you have the right tools, you know. But as I said again, won't work with all of them.
Look at that. Look at that lock nut there. No, look at that piece of shit.
Well, you got only one here. How many you have?
I got one on each wheel.
Really?
There's yeah.
There's none on this.
Okay, maybe not on that one.
Oh, sometimes get in it, just make. See, this one doesn't want to get a hold of. This one's not getting a hold of this lock.
Oh shit.
Sometimes you have to tap him a bit.
Ah, okay. So we got a big hammer there, guys. What do you call it? This car's got no front brakes, and so I was trying to take the front wheels off to put brakes in it, but I drove it here with no brakes. Oh, no front brakes. Oh my goodness.
Please don't slip.
Who's the man? Oh yeah.
That's Jack. Alright, last one.
Awesome. Nearly there.
Just you have to try not to get a grip on it from the first time, because if it slips sometimes you can't get a grip on it a second time. You have to go smaller size.
Oh, it looks like you got it. Oh, you got it. What a boss. So all in all, I guess you could say I was correct in how to remove the lock nuts. You are meant to get the size that just does fit, and you hammer it on, as you could see Bill do down at TyreMaster. Now, I didn't exactly have the correct tools, and I wasn't really looking at spending $200 on buying the correct set, so I just drove down there, made it easier for myself. Now, I guess this is gonna be a weird how-to video, but I guess you could also say it's how to drive down to a mechanic and then let them do the job. But it also could be taken as a learning curve on how to do things, on what Bill's advice has given to you. Now, I did try this myself, and if you aren't able to do it yourself, always feel free to go down to a mechanic and DI and let them do it for you. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. It's kind of a weird video. It's short. It's a how-to, but it's not even how-to. Let me know if you liked it down in the comments below. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe button, as I'm always trying to make you guys some awesome content. Now, next video, if my parts haven't come in, I'm going to teach you guys how to remove brake pads or change your brake pads in the EG Civic. So keep in touch till then. Cheers, fam, and peace out.